Important thing to say that I found out some of you, around 20% or nearly 30% of students in the class, you copy the lab from your friends. That is really, really bad thing. I have talked to Dr. Natasha that students shouldn't. I found out about 30% of your class copy the lab from your friends. That is really bad thing. So I'm gonna say that it's a warning call for me that if next time I found anyone copy any lab or anything from your friend, I use the similarity detector. So it will detect that you done your work very, very similar to your friend. And if I found it, yes, you copy from your friend, I'm gonna deduct your score in that lab to be
sure.
Channel what?
I sorry.
Okay, I'm fine. Yeah. So next time, if I found anyone copy the lab from your friend or copy anything from your friend, I'm gonna deduct the lab score to be zero and deduct your midterm score by 5 point. 5 point is low point. It means that if you gonna get B plus grade, it's gonna be B grade. So if you're gonna be, get D grade, you're gonna get F from it. So don't submit your friend lab. And if I found that you copy from your friend 2 times, you're gonna get F from this class. This is a warning call for me. So next time, I hope all of you guys don't submit any copy from your friend. Also, a guy who keep code from your friend, you still got deduct as same as copier. All right. So don't copy from your friend and don't give your code to anyone. If I found out the first time, you're gonna get 0 from that lab and -5 score in law point at the end of the term. And if I found second time, you're gonna get F from this class. This is really clear for me, right? Anyone here? Because I found a lot of you guys copy from your friend and submit to the gate. If you can't do, it's fine. The lab score are not that big. And I'm gonna know that, okay, you can't do it. I'm gonna make it easier, or we can make a wrap up class to teaching you guys how to do it. But if you copy from your friend, I'm gonna deduct your score from someone who sent the code and someone who copied the code. All right, I'm gonna show the lab for today. Let me 10 seconds. 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, right. Gonna share my screen right now. I have to say today's lab is quite hard, really, really hard. We have two questions that is really, really hard. But yeah, and I say, if you can't do it, it's fine because the lab score is that big. And we're gonna know that, okay, I have really, really a too hard problem, so I can make it easier. Or if I see someone who can't do any lab, so we can make a wrap up class to help you gain much more knowledge. Copy from your friend is really, really bad thing from the copier and someone who sent the code for your friend. All right, let's start for the lab. I'm gonna explain every 7 question. The first question is LCM. You may know that this common multiple. You have done this lab before, but today I want you to using a recursive function. The recursive function that you learn in the class, the function that call themselves and call it over and over and over until they get the answer. So I ask you guys to make the least common multiple LCM or coronal to answer this question using recursive function only. Also, if error occur, they have a case that they have order, you have to output the order. I don't want to show which case order, so you can have to think it carefully. It's only have one case that can be order in the LCM. Right, the first question is not that hard. The second question is hailstone. Hailstone is one of very popular mathematics question. That is, they say they have someone who tore the lock and is hit the ground and is burn up. So if the number that you input an odd number, the next number is gonna be 3 times that number plus 1, But if that number are even, it's gonna be divided by two, and it will be n if the number are one. What does it mean is that if I input 13, it means that I told the log at the height 13 met, the 13 meter, and I told it. So you output me the first time that it hit the gas with 13, and it's go to the rule number one, that is if number is us, it's gonna be t time plus one, so it's gonna be 40. So then it'd be 40, it's an even number, so it's divided by two. It's gonna be giving you 20, and follow the rule, 20 go to 10, go to five. Okay, five is odd number, so it's t time plus one again, so it'd be 16, then go to eight, four, two, one. So basically you give me array that is, I'll put the first number and the last number is always one, but you have to say what is the number that have been to. Right. Oh, sorry, this one is misclick. Let me fix it. Let me turn the hailstone. Okay, so you have to pin the first number also. Right. So if number is three, so you pin three, then 10, then five, then 16, then eight, then four, then two, then one. All right, this is a hailstone. Next problem is the power of 2, 3, 4. So it's very easy. Every question today, you have to use recursive function to do it. So the lab number 3 is the power of 2, 3, 4. So I give you number, you check me that this number are powered by 2, powered by 3, powered by 4 or not, bin me 2 or 4. So if I input 16, 16 is powered by 2, right? Because 2 powered by 4 is 16, so it's 2. And 16 can be powered by 3, right? Because we have never have number that 3 powered by something gonna be 16, so you say 4. And 16 can be powered by 4 because 4 powered by 2 is 16, so you give me 2. Just very easy. Tell me that this number are powered by 2, 3, 4 or not. Give me 2 and 4. And you have to use recursive function. Okay, for the 30 question, it's really easy. It's not that hard. You can do by yourself, absolutely. But the fourth and the fifth question is a little bit hard. This question is last one. Last one, what does it mean? Last one is you have to tell me what is someone who is the last remaining number if I give you the array in increasing order. So if I say the input is only number 5, but if I say 5, it means that the array input is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If I say 9, the array input is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So if I say 10, it absolutely means the array input is 1 to 10. And you have to give me the last remaining number. Then how are we gonna think about it? How are we gonna know what is the last remaining number? So the last one is say that the first rule is start from the left to right, remove the first number and every other number afterward until you reach the end of the list. So what I mean is that I think it's maybe better if I see give you more example. Okay. So if I see you, if I give you 10, right, from the start, you're gonna get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, right? Then from the rule number one, they say that remove the first number and every other number afterward. So it means that number one, number three, number five, number seven, number nine, gonna be removed. So the left is number 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Then you do the rule number two, repeat the previous step, but start from right to left. So the first number from the left, sorry, from the right will be removed, and the other number will be removed. So 10, 6 and 2 gonna be removed. Then the left is 4 and 8, right? And they say keep repeating this the step again. So start from the left to right, remove, then left, right to left, remove, then left to right, remove until you get only single number left. So after we got only 4 and 8, number 4 have to be removed. So then the left is number 8. So you output me number 8, something like that. If I give you 10, so it means that you have to hear it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 to 10, then remove the first number and every other number like this. After it removed, do it the same way, but start from the left. Sorry, start from the right. So for the end of the array, 10, 6, 2 have to be removed. Then start it over again. Start over, 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 over until you get only one number. Then you pin me the last remaining number. Also, this is the lead code exam, the code that a lot of programmer who would like to practice the algorithm would be using this question to practice themselves. So I think all of you guys, after studying from the C programming for a few months, you have ability to solve this question. Also, this one can solve with the recursive function, but if you are really expert in mathematics, that can solve by using a mathematic equation, only one line of code, you get the answer. But that is one is really, really hard. So I recommend you to answer in recursive function. But if you know the math equation, it's fine for me to submit that answer. Right. Next one is the same, the last one, but in the circle. The last one in the circle, what does it mean? And this one I made the image for all of you guys to understand it much more. Let me show the image. Because in this in Gator, I can't submit the image. So I'm gonna send in the live chat. But let's say the least one, the last one, circle. So it's the same thing that we have to do in the last question, but in circle. What I mean is that I'm gonna give you the number of people in the circle and how many number to count. Then the rule is that we start with the first person, then they count. So if I say like this one, I'm gonna send in the live chat soon, but this one. So I say that, okay, we have 5 person in the group and we count number 2. What it mean is that people number 1 gonna say 1, right? And next person gonna say 2. Then if they say 2, they're gonna remove from the group and we start all over again. So person number 3 say 1, person number 4 say 2, 4 remove from the group. Person number 5 say 1, person number 1 say 2, 1 remove from the group. Person number 3 say 1, sorry, person number 3 say 1, person number 2, sorry, number 5 say 2, number 5 remove from the group, and the number 3 is the winner. He is the last person on the group. So I just give you the number of person on the group and number count to be removed. So if I say 10 person in the group and 4, it means that we have 10 person, they sit in a circle, and they count number 1, 2, 3, 4, who count number 4 gonna be removed, something like that. So I'm gonna send the image in the live chat because I'm sorry that the Gator can't show the image. So I have to show you guys in the live chat. All right. This is picture lab number 8, 5, n equal to 5 and k equal to 2. So I just give you number of people and how many number we count gonna be removed, and you output me the winner or the last remaining one. This one really similar to the lab number 4, lab 8, 4, but this one is more a little bit more complicated. I advise all of you guys to do in the recursive function. But if you expert in mathematics, you can think about the math equation to answer this question. Okay, right. For the question number six is move. This one really easy, but I would like you to practicing in function passed by reference. Teacher Natasha have taught you about how to swap number by passing the reference, right? So this one is a little bit more really, really easy. If you listen carefully when Dr. Natasha talks, you're gonna do this lab really, really fine. So I give you a list, sorry, an array of number. I say how many range of the array, I say five. So the array is a number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, something like that. And you're gonna give me back the array that every number step by one. What it means step by one is they swap their index by one, and the last index gonna be the first index. Oh, sorry, the first index gonna be the last index. So what I mean is that at the start of array, they are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and it's step by one. So you give me 2, 3, 4, 5, 1. So a number two that are index number one, now they are index number zero. Number three, that index number two gonna be index number one, and so on. And the first index number zero gonna be the last index. So another example that I give you three number of array, this is 1, 2, 5, you're gonna give me back 2, 5, 1. Very easy if you understand how to pass by reference. Okay, the last question is good digits. This one is also easy. That I give you a number, you tell me 2 or 4 is a good digit or not. And how we know this is a good digit or not is that if in the even index, they are even number, and if their odd index are prime number, it's a good digit. That is very easy. Actually, this one you can do in recursive or not in the recursive function, but this is a recursive lab. So please do in the recursive function. So for example, this one is 4T07. 4 is index number 0, right? So it's an even index. So it have to be even number. Number 3 is index number 1. So it's an odd index. So it have to be prime number. And the next index is 0. There is an index number 2 is an even index, so it have to be even number. And the last is 7 is a third index, is an odd index, so it have to be prime number. So all of it are followed by the rule that I give, so it will be 2. That is, and if it's not, gonna be 4. And you don't have to think about, it's never gonna have a test case that start by 0. You don't have to think about that case. We not have a 0 test case. I mean that we are not have 0 reading test case. So don't think about that case. Okay, so this is all for today. We have 7 labs. The lab number 4 and 5 is quite a bit hard, really, really hard. I have to say for a beginner in the C programming, but I think all of you guys have ability to do that. And the list is really, really easy. So anyone have a question? And I say again that you do not copy any lab from your friend. So I have a question that in case you and your friend have a really similar logic or similar variable. Most of people have the same logic. It's fine for me. The same logic is really fine because some lab they have many different algorithms to solve, but some lab only have one process to solve. So if you have similar logic, it's fine. But I looking at the how you the right variable, how you construct the how you enter, how you tap, how you name the variable, something like that. And if I found that more than 95% of your code are matching from your friend is gonna be as a copy, I'm gonna warning you, you can defend that if you do not copy from your friend. But as I say, if I found anyone copy, the first time you're gonna get 0 in that lab and deduct 5 score at the end of the term. And if you copy from the second time, you're gonna get F from this code. And I have a warning sign for about 18 students right now that they copy from the fan, but today I do not want like to deduct all of you guys, so this is a warning. But if you do next time, I'm gonna deduct your score and might not find score in your law score in the end of the term, right? Okay, anyone have any problem? Anyone have something to ask? Because today's lab is really, really complicated, especially in the lab number 4 and number 5. Also, don't submit lab number 7 right now because the test kit is a bit bugged. Let me solve it for another 5 minutes. So if you have any, don't have any question, you can do the lab right now, but don't submit lab number 8, 7 for 10 minutes. Let me solve the bug first. Okay, happy coding and don't copy your friend codes.
Okay, because someone want me to upload P. Anon talking about this lab, right? So I will shut down the Zoom for a while and then I will upload the files and then I will come back again. Is that okay? Or will we wait until the Zoom session finished today? Because the details of each lab are in details, are very complicated. I think maybe you will need to understand about it carefully. Uh-huh. What do you think, Anon?
I'm fine with any, but I think if you confused about the lab, better ask me than see the clip, because if you see the clip, you still be confused. If you confuse anything, ask me. You can ask me in Thai if you don't understand English very well.
Okay, maybe I will wait until 1.5 hours and then I will upload the clip. Okay, so just in any case that you are confused about the lab, right? You can ask Anon directly in this Zoom. Okay. I'm wondering about where are the students, because there are only 50 students in this Zoom. Where are they? I think I have to check for the class attendance because the lab session is also important. So could you please type 7 into the chat line here? So I will check for the class attendance. Mm-hmm. Because it is 30 minutes already. Am I right, Anon?
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah, they are still outside the Zoom session. Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you very much. Please enjoy the lab, right? Mm-hmm.
Okay, I have fixed the bug in the lab number 7, so you guys can submit in lab number 7 right now. Also, I would like to remind all of you that the problem number one, the LCM, that is really have one hard test case that's gonna be error for the LCM. You have to output error. But I don't say which test case, you have to think carefully which one gonna be output error.
For this lab question, do the students have to solve about the recurrence formula for the LCM? Okay, they can employ from the GCD.
Yeah, so basically LSA is really easy, this one, because you guys know about the LCM, right? You have done the lab before, but this one I just adapt that you have to use recursive function only and think about the one hard test case that's gonna be output error.